Greetings, Joyce here from rigidheddleweaving.com. We're going to learn how to warp our loom front to back. Now that you have your warp chains made, locate the cross of your warp chain, find the loop at the end, and slip it over the middle finger of your hand. What you're going to do is cut the threads at the center of the loop. There, I've located the cross, slipped the loop over my middle finger. Now I'm going to get that first really tight choke. Give a slight pull, not too hard. You just want to straighten everything out so you can find the center of the loop. Once the center of the loop is located, you're going to snip all the threads. Put my thumb behind the cross, put my middle finger back in the loop, and I'll hang on to them with my fingers and give a little snip. Now we're ready to start threading the reed. You'll see I've already got one warp chain already threaded with a safety knot at the end. Because once you get this threaded, you will be transporting your reed to your loom. Undo your tie. Now at the cross, there is always a top thread. So, oops, sorry, hit the wire on the camera. Now using either a heddle hook, or what I like to use is a simple double-ended knitting needle, I'm going to locate the top thread from the cross, remove it from my hand, and thread it through the reed. Hang on to that tight choke, straighten it out just a little bit, not too much, don't pull too hard, just enough to straighten it. Locate the top thread, remove it, make a loop. Now pinch this with your fingers and your thumb. I have a nice loop here now. Go to my reed, the next slot in the reed. I'm going to stick my needle through, put the loop on the end of the needle, and pull the thread through. That's all there is to this process. Continue all the way across. Find the top thread, remove it, make a loop, hang onto it, go to the next slot in the reed, pull it through. Once your reed is completely threaded, bring it over to your loom and put it in the beater. I've already started threading the heddles. There's those really tight chokes. Do not remove those quite yet. Here's how I thread the heddles. I simply locate the next thread from the reed. Bring over my heddle. Make a loop here. Bring the heddle over. Stick the loop through the eye, pull it through. That's all there is to this. Find the next thread, make a loop, poke the loop through the eye of the heddle, pull it through. When I have about 8 heddles threaded, I like to go ahead and double check my work. It's better to find your mistakes now than later. So go ahead and double check yourself, make sure they're threaded correctly. Then if the ends are uneven, go ahead and even them out. They don't have to be perfect, just get them as close as possible. Do not make yourself crazy. I'm not a perfectionist, so I just get them as even as I can. Now tie the bundle into an overhand knot with a thread or cord or string that's attached to the beam stick. You're going to make a lark's head knot in the string, and you know what you're going to do is slip the knot on the warp through that loop to attach it to the bean stick. So there's the loop. Put the knot through there and give a little pull, and that's it. You're attached to the warp beam now. Actually, to the beam stick. Now that you've finished threading your heddles, it's time to bring the warp from the front of the loom under the breast beam up and over the castle. You'll see that I still have my chokes tied, but once I have this completed, once my warps are all over the castle, I'll go ahead and remove the chokes. Now we're ready to start beaming with the crank and yank method. Crank and yank method is exactly as is implied. Crank the beam, the warp beam, and then yank on the warp chains to tighten them onto the beam. Here's another crank, and another yank on each of the chains. Now while you're doing this, keep an eye on the reed at the front of the loom to make sure that no tangles are developing. You'll be able to tell because it'll start to get hard to turn the handle on the beam. If you notice some tangles that are developing, go to the front of the loom, check to see where they are, and I'll show you how to untangle them quite easily in the next step. Go ahead and put some tension on the strings. Sometimes just pulling on it will do it, but strum it like a guitar. All the strings will fall right into place. There's no need to comb, no need to stroke, no need to make yourself crazy. Just a little bit of tension and strum like a guitar, and they all fall right into place. Okay, going along doing the crank and yank, and you find that your warps, as you get near the end especially, they start getting a little wonky. So what you do is put some tension on it, strum it like a guitar again, or I don't know how to describe this, but you grab a bunch in your hand and you let go of the strings as you move your hand to the side. You'll see me do this in just a minute. Right there. You pick and pull, I guess. Have tension on it, do a pick and pull, and let go as you kind of move your fingers across it, right there. That gets all the tangles out from the back. Again, you don't have to comb it, you don't have to stroke it. Just put some tension and flick the strings, and they all straighten themselves out. As you reach the end of the warp, go ahead and add warp extenders. This is the same way that you attached it to the beanstick. Just take some cording, make a lark's head knot, wrap it around the knots at the ends of the warp, hang on to it as you turn. This puts tension on it. Just hang on to it while you wind on. Once the knots in the warp reach the breast beam, then you can let the whole thing go. Keeping tension. Almost there. Now you want to give your warps a haircut. Find a spot on the loom to use as a guide and just cut them all at the same spot, just like cutting hair. It's time to attach the warps to your beam stick. I like to start from the middle and work my way out to the sides. What I do is I'll grab two groups of eight. I'm going to bring these around the beam stick from the top. Come from behind the beam stick. Pull the tag end around to the front again. Now I have these two tag ends and I will tie them together in a simple overhand knot. Do this all the way across your loom. Now that they're all attached, you're going to check your tension. Some will be looser and some will be tighter. This is where you go and even them out. Just grab those two tag ends, pull up, tie it tighter. Do this all the way across. Give another feel. I'm still not satisfied. The ones on the left here are a little bit looser than the ones on the right. Do it one more time. A little faster here. Speeding up the film. And check that tension one more time. Yes, everything feels good now. I'm going to go ahead and tie these in a bow. Some people like to tie in a second overhand knot, but I like to use a bow just in case I made a mistake in my threading. I can undo that section easily, fix my mistake, and keep going. One last check on that tension. Everything feels really good. Now I'm ready to start weaving. I start by throwing three shots of the thread and then beading. Some people put all kinds of stuff in here. They'll put toilet paper, tissue paper, yarn, rags, whatever. I just throw three shots and then bead. It's usually enough to straighten everything out. It's called the header. So there's my first shot. Comes the second one, and you'll notice I have not beat this yet. And one last shot. Now I'm ready to beat. And you see right here how everything is all straightened out. I hope you've enjoyed this demo. Please stop by my website for more on weaving. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for commenting, and thank you for rating. Until next time, this is RigidHeddleWeaving.com. Happy weaving!